Here we are again. We got excellent news, and it stated 23 hours ago, although this article is actually stated May 5th, 2021, which is today, presented by Matthew Williams. Covers the government here. We've got this on American Action News. And in fact, when I re-Googled it, I didn't get anyone else covering it. I did see a link somewhere that Fox had referred to this, but when I went to get more information, the link didn't go through. So apparently this is moving through. So here we go. We have American Action News. AOC pushes for massive climate core army of 1.5 million people. So let's look at what this actually is. 1.5 million men and or women, but people, an army climate core released throughout the domestic continental U.S. to tell you and I what to do. Before we click on this, I want to go into what a difference a year makes. And this is from Military Times. And back to Maine. Let's see if I can just pull this back up then so you can at least see it. You know, I get everything queued up in here, and we've got these blockers for a reason. AOC. Proposes measure two. Do you remember this? Put an end to military recruiting. Okay, we're just going to look at it quickly. I guess it'll flash on the screen and then go away here. So this was July 23rd, 2020. The proposed amendment to the House Appropriations Bill would prohibit government funds from supporting military presence on escorts platforms. And so it goes on. AOC is proposing the measure to put an end to the military recruiting. So again, this will probably flash on the screen. You might need to pause it in order to read. But this was July 23, 2020. AOC proposes measure to put an end to military recruiting using this particular team. And so after a whole year of what we faced, you can go ahead and read this again. This comes from Military Times, and I'm scrolling just so that before that blocker comes up that you can look at it. So let me go back to the article today. So that was a year ago. So what does this mean? We have all lived through an absolutely inexcusable year of lockdowns. We witnessed the separation of a city from the United States, the autonomous zone in Seattle. Yep, that really happened. We witnessed all the challenges in Portland and Minneapolis, among other cities. We witnessed governors who turned down assistance from a federal level and encourage riots and uprising in their city, specifically going out into the crowd and telling them to stand up and use force if necessary, while yelling to defund the police. We saw a number of incidents that exemplify this, and I'm not going to go through images or pictures, but just recently we saw a Democratic representative fly from California to Minnesota prior to the announcement of a verdict to tell people to take physical action if needed. We are being told one thing, and we are being told that the police need to be defunded. We're already very much aware that the media is not on our side. They're painting a narrative and a picture based on their agenda. But the statement that I want to move to here is the Democrats in this case, which this just happens to be the party moving forward at this point, but the Democrats, or they, if we say that, quote unquote, they want police. They are playing a psychological game. So what happens when they allow for defunding of police and the police step back? That's right. We've seen that in Batman. It's called Gotham City. However, anytime a governor or U.S. representative travels, moves around, they have at the least Secret Service. Many of them have their own weapons on them. Many of them are having their family protected through private security. They want police. They want police for themselves, and they want police for you. but they don't want you being the police. They don't want people from your community that you might know. They want to lessen that all the way until we are on our hands and knees living in a Gotham City, and we step forward screaming for the government, big government, to step in with the solution. They don't want any more of the small government or states' powers or rights of the city. They want big government to step in, and they want us to demand that that happens. So this is the path they've created of the swinging one direction. And here we go. AOC pushes for mass climate core army of 1.5 million. Let's just take a gander. Far-left Democrat AOC and her radical allies in Congress are now calling for a massive new army to be formed to fight climate change. Their proposal is for a climate crops of up to 1.5 million members over 5 years. So a little bit more details of this, but you're gathering and coordinating 1.5 million Americans domestically in order to sign on to this agreement. Now, what have we seen? The Democrats love to throw money at us. They love to let the drippings off the table come to us, and we're supposed to stand in gratitude while our works are shut down, childcare shut down, schools are shut down, and yet the pittance of one day's salary gets thrown out into the crowd, and we're supposed to yell and celebrate. That's just like going to listen to a speaker and clapping every time they pause. No, you don't clap every time somebody pauses. If in fact they are do something in alignment with a movement that you know in your heart is the right direction, you can signal a salute via clapping or vocal support. But just because somebody is in a leadership position, stands there and pauses, and a sign goes up saying clap or no, we are not puppets. Stand up for yourself. What is going on is not in our best interest. So here we have AOC pulling together or moving to pull together 1.5 million people. Let's just call it what it is. 1.5 million people in an army. This is communism being structured throughout the United States. So what are these 1.1 million people going to do? Hey, it's jobs. We need jobs, right? No, you know what? We had a pipeline that got shut down. We have H-1B visa holders in here that are taking massive amounts of jobs. After doing this last tax season, the only individuals that I helped serve doing full service tax returns who earned over $400,000 a year, the only ones that came to our platform were H-1B visa holders. The only ones. And the data that I broke down beyond that is even more depressing of what happened. So what we need to look at is, what does this mean? Now, I will point out, in the late 1970s, early 1980s, in San Francisco, California, there were an estimated 9,000 to 10,000 undercover CIA agents. And when I say undercover, that doesn't mean that they were CIA trained at, I think it's Langley, and then vetted and moved on. They tackled a wider breadth of individuals. They would slide them money for communication, giving tips. And this would be on a regular basis. So this might be the postal person, a liquor store, the laundromat, people in your community that you might smile to, walk by, say hi to, even watch their children, or you might watch their children. Almost 10,000 of them in the late 70s, early 80s, were reporting to the CIA. Let's fast forward now to 2021. Do you think that number's higher or lower? Well, I don't have those figures right now. Even if FOIA requests were sent, that's not something that's immediately tracked that we'd be able to find out, because most of that are our cash rewards and other agreements that are passive that escape FOIA, or they might pass through private companies. So we're not going to find that. But what I can tell you is, yes, that number is immensely higher. Why? Because you probably have a cell phone in your pocket. Does this cell phone track where you are? Does it monitor your communication, text messages, emails? Does it all go into one location of a cloud service that is constantly being streamed by machine learning and AI? Yes, we are being tracked every day. The difference here is AOC wants to take 1.5 million people throughout the United States that are already loved and part of their community, and have them start reporting back. This might even be likened to census. When we went through the census a few months ago, I believe we should all do our part. Why do the census workers have to show up to my house 7 different times and ask my neighbors about me? This is what's going on with this climate crops 1.5 million million member or million men, million people merge. This is big government. We don't need it. It's not good. And it's just one switch over from arming them if we need to. Now, clearly, climate crops, you know what? Our climate is in a really bad situation. We must save this planet. Scratch that. Wake up. Again, if you learned it on CNN, is it true? Pay attention to what's going out there. Why would they need this? So let's look at this. Rep. AOC and other progressive lawmakers are calling for the creation of this civilian to work on federally funded projects addressing climate change as part of their sweeping Green New Deal. Members of the Civilian Climate Corps would receive, well, that sure sounds like CCP, except for it's CCC, sure similar there, would receive on-the-job training and work with community groups on initiatives, reduce carbons, enable transition to renewable energy, build healthy and more resilient communities, implement conservation projects with proven climate benefits, and help communities recover faster. This would fall under the purview of Corporation for Natural and Community National and Community Service, an independent government agenda that also runs AmeriCorps and National Service Initiatives. So who speaks out? The individual that is now used to getting, you know, whatever it is, $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000, $9,000 a month to be part of this force, and if they speak out negatively, then they lose their job? No, that's not the person that's going to speak out. By binding these people together, we have a lot more people that are going to report. And, you know, from high school, we learned the term NARC. That doesn't necessarily mean that reporting is good for society, as we've seen in our cancel culture. And it certainly doesn't mean that it's always honest or truthful. Once you get into a system, we have McCarthyism pop up, where just because somebody crossed another path, they can be reported. And innocent until proven guilty does not move forward in a core like that, where you've got civilians in these roles. So really pay attention to what moves forward out of this massive CCC or CCP army initiative of 1.5 million people in the United States. And I'm going to tell you, these jobs are going to be floating out there. I have specific job sites that I'm just not going to name here because I'm not going to encourage it, that post the federal jobs. This is not a path you want to go down. Big government is not the solution. The Constitution was set up so that each state maintains its power and authority with just basic glue from the federal level. And even when the federal government determines that we are to go to war, they must have buy-in from the states, because who's going to go to war? Not a federal entity, but the individuals that live in each state. Who's going to pay for the war? Not a federal entity, but the individual taxpayers in states. Our Constitution was set up in order to protect us. This is not on the path of a small government. This is big government. This is big government in your business. This is big government moving forward in the mask of helping to solve a problem that, quite honestly, doesn't exist, in order to sheep us into, well, you know where this ends up. So once again, I'm going to click on this. This is May 5th, 2021, the original story to remove. AOC proposed to measure and end military recruiting July 23rd. And again, we're not going to go through the whole list of everything else that's out there. Now, before we proceed, I want to point out once again that I don't put any commercials in my videos. So if you are seeing commercials, that's courtesy of YouTube. I am not monetized, and YouTube just goes ahead and splatters those into videos when they want to pull back the viewership. But I wanted to say, vote with your money. Here we go. I talked about this yesterday. I'm going to keep pushing this. Microsoft is not the solution. Stop funding a direction that is not helping us out. LibreOffice.org is a solution. It's a free open source of Word presentation, Excel, everything that you would need within a Word format, I'm sorry, an Office Suite format, except it's right here, LibreOffice through the Document Foundation. You can download right on their site. In addition to that, start looking for free options. The universities have held us hostage for way too long. Again, I haven't vetted this university. I haven't attended there and gone through the program to see the validity. So please do that on your own. However, this is touted as tuition free. They do have fees and even scholarships for those fees. It's University of the People, the Education Revolution. This is meant to allow everybody to get an education who wants one without becoming an indentured servitude via immense debt coming out of the program. All right, let's just close it out here. This is the March to Save America. Together we are rebuilding our nation.